growth of San Diego State has closely paralleled the growth of the city of San Diego. San Diego began as a resort town on the Blue Pacific, a quiet town with simple tastes and an easygoing approach toward life. One's first picture of San Diego State is that of a small college on a big mesa overlooking the city. The architecture is predominantly Spanish, and the landscaping is replete with palm trees and exotic plants. Much like the typical Spanish hacienda, the college was planned around a courtyard. But the college let the community know it was there. The massive bell tower towered over the surrounding landscape and served as a beacon of learning to the town that lay below. Life was good at San Diego State. The air was fresh, the sun beat hot, and the campus had a timeless quality. This is Monty, short for Montezuma, a somewhat unusual patron saint for a seat of learning. He sits surveying his domain and typifies the early spirit of San Diego State. All things come to him who waits. What did Monty see? Nothing too unusual in terms of the academic life. A typical small-town college of less than 3,000 students, dedicated mostly to graduating teachers for California's growing communities. The quality of education was good, and like most schools of its size, it boasted a few outstanding departments. Forensics and theater have always been strong here, as well as the sciences and business administration. The college boasted as well the advantages of a small school. The classes were small, and the faculty had the opportunity to get to know the individual student. They could still hold classes in the cafeteria over a cup of coffee, and a field trip in English or philosophy was not unknown. You could still graduate from San Diego State and be acquainted with a good portion of those who walked down the aisle with you to get their diplomas. And you could always find a place to be alone when you needed solitude. The tempo of the times began to change. The GIs were coming home, and it seemed as if they brought their machinery with them. The old life disappeared, and in its place appeared a vigor of approach and a cacophony of sound. New buildings seemed to appear before your very eyes, and the sidewalks became as crowded as a New York subway. Every time the sun rose, it looked upon a changed campus. As new buildings were completed, they more than doubled the square footage of the old campus. The buildings were new and modern, creations of steel and concrete, buildings without a soul, until the students poured in and made them their own. A humanities and a social science building, a physics building, an art building, an extension of the library twice as large as the old building and housing nearly a quarter of a million volumes. A life science building containing almost 150,000 square feet of classroom space. This is San Diego State today, a study in continual growth. From the temple of a small college, the institution has evolved into a complex of driving energy. Expansion occurs in every direction. Is there a canyon to the east of the college? Fill it. Is there a canyon to the south? Fill it. Is there a huge canyon to the west of campus? Then hire a fleet of trucks, day and night for over a year, and fill it. Aware of the dangers of rapid expansion, San Diego's quality of instruction has not suffered. If anything, it has increased. New departments have been created and others expanded to fit the needs of a growing community in burgeoning California. Engineering, physics, mathematics have been vastly expanded to meet the needs of space-age technology. Does General Dynamics Astronautics need missile engineers? San Diego State can furnish them. Does a General Atomic need experimental atomic physicists? They can find them in their own backyard. The growth of broadcasting at San Diego State perhaps best typifies both the college's growth and its attitude. In the beginning, its facilities were housed in temporary buildings on a faraway corner of the campus. But as the school began to grow, so did broadcasting. Going from classroom exercises to the newly acquired radio and television studios with a station operation. This is KEBS, the educational broadcast service of San Diego State. Because of its location, KEBS can and does serve as a training ground for broadcasting students. But its service is to the San Diego community at large. KEBS is communication at work. What does a person learn in broadcasting at San Diego State? Above all, he learns to be a broadcaster. The emphasis is in production, direction, and responsibility. The responsibility comes in many forms. As you see, here the radio station is student-operated. While pursuing his coursework, the ambitious student can gain experience in almost every facet. The conditions are real, and the concern is genuine. There are other types of responsibility the student learns. The responsibility to the community and the programming the students do. The responsibility to themselves in fulfilling the limits of artistic integrity as well as good business sense. And perhaps most important of all, they learn that while broadcasting is not always fun, it is always fruitful. And everywhere and always crops up the phrase, the public interest. Broadcasting's own version of the Hippocratic Oath.
Educational Broadcasting Service of San Diego State. KEBS is owned by the state of California and operated by San Diego State.
It is in the field of television at San Diego State that broadcasting has been most ambitious. The facilities are first rate. Its two fully equipped studios and related technical gear enable State nearly everything a large commercial station is capable of doing. A modern videotape machine, electronic editor, network quality lighting panels and grids, facilities for slides, kinescope and film, facilities for closed and open circuit television, educational television, instructional television, commercial television, film, all can be done here. A typical week's work at the San Diego State Studios would include 8 hours of instructional closed-circuit television in the fields of health education and psychology, 1 hour of educational television for commercial presentation in San Diego stations, including a high-quality children's program, 1 to 3 hours of programming geared to the California school systems, commercial spots, and student projects. The program becomes impressive when it is realized that all of these programs are student-produced and directed under faculty supervision and is, in essence, a training on-the-money situation. Students have left San Diego State with as many as 40 hours of directing experience behind them. Although attention is given to how you direct and how you produce, these faculties are secondary to how well you've fulfilled your function as a producer or as a director. San Diego State believes wholly in student-oriented production and direction, but the results are not judged on supposed student capabilities. Instead, the criteria are based on professional standards, both in the sense of production quality and in the sense of fulfilling the obligation to the viewer. It is the belief of the broadcast faculty of San Diego State that communication is an art. An art that has, in its essence, both moral and artistic responsibilities. In a world that steadily grows smaller, the art of communication looms larger upon the scene. And in a medium that often cries long for responsibility, student representatives from San Diego State are being trained to fulfill the requirements. The broadcasting department of San Diego State is a challenge to its students, and it's up to them to meet that challenge. Thank you.